Hey kids, welcome to another Scratch programming video with Miss Bethany. Today we're going to use the clone tool to make a cool effect for the mouse pointer. Go to the Scratch website and you can follow along with these steps.
In this video, we'll make a sparkling effect for the mouse pointer. We're going to use Scratch 3.0, and this is the offline editor. The sprites we use will either be available in the Scratch library, or they will be dots and star shapes that you can easily draw. When it's finished, the project will look like this, sort of like there's confetti floating around the mouse pointer. If you're using the Scratch website, it might look a little different, but the blocks and the logic will basically be the same. We'll start out by switching the cat sprite for a different sprite that'll look a little more fun and magic-like. And for that, we'll choose the crystal. Let's begin by giving it more costumes. By clicking on the costume tab, we can see all the extra costumes that it would have up here. We'll right-click the top one and choose duplicate. The more we make, the better. So for this, we'll make 10 costumes all in all. 3 of the blue and 3 of the purple. When this is done, we'll color each gem differently. We'll make a few more costumes at the end. We'll make 2 round dots of different sizes, and we'll make 2 star shapes. Back in the code tab, we need to make 4 code blocks to animate this. The program will start with the green flag, so we'll find that block first. And we want it to run forever, so we'll attach a forever loop to it. Now we'll need to add 2 blocks inside this. The first will make the sprite follow the mouse pointer, and the second will make it create clones. If you test the code at this point, it should look like this. Now, make the second code block. It will also start with the green flag click. I'm going to set the sprite to 50% of its size because I like how that looks better, although this isn't really necessary for the program. You can leave it at the full size if you like that better. After that, we're going to add another forever loop. This will have 2 blocks inside it as well. The purple switch costume block will go first, and we'll tell it to choose any of the costumes randomly. Since, as you can see in the costume tab, there are 10, we will put 1 to 10 in the random block. The last block in this loop will be a point and direction block. And we want this to be random as well, so we'll set the choice to 1 to 360. So that it can point in all directions. Testing the code again should now make it look like this. The costume is switching rapidly, as you can see. Now we want the clones to do something very similar. Get the When I Start as a Clone event block. You can right-click and duplicate the last two blocks you made because they're going to go in first. Under them, we need a repeat loop. We'll set it to 10. What we want to happen 10 times is for the clone to move a random number of steps. We'll set this from 1 to 5. And then we want the ghost effect to change. If you didn't already know, the ghost effect makes the sprite fade out. You can click Clear Graphic Effects to make it look normal again. Once these blocks have run, we want the clone to disappear, so we'll add that block last. Finally, just for fun, we'll add a sound effect. The crystal sprite has the magic spell sound attached to it, and it's pretty good for this, so we'll use it. And we'll set it to run when we click the sprite. Now let's test the code again, and as you can see, the effect is pretty good. Now what if we wanted something else for this? Let's go back to the costume tab and switch out the crystal gems for something equally magical and a little more delicious. Tacos. We'll start by adding the taco costume to the very bottom of the costume list. Right-click the taco and duplicate it twice. We'll change the colors around a bit to give it some variety. Finally, just for fun, we'll add some nachos to this. We can easily draw a tan triangle shape, fill it in with a paint bucket, and then add some dots with the brush. It helps to look more textured if you use different sizes of dots. We now have 3 tacos and 2 nachos, which, as you can see, are costumes 11 through 15. Costumes 7, 8, 9, and 10 are the dots and the stars that we made, so let's remember that we want to use costumes 7 to 15 to switch our gems to tacos. And back in the code tab, we will change the random block to say 7 to 15. Testing it again, it looks pretty good. And now let's test our third magical object, the llama. Again, we'll add the costume at the end, but this time of the llama. Since this is a bigger sprite, we're going to need to use the select arrow. We'll drag it over the entire costume, and then we'll click on the blue node and drag this up to make it smaller. Once the llama is smaller, we can change the color. We'll duplicate it a couple times. And then we'll add the stars and dots to the end. We could code the random costume choice to pick the star shapes that are already there, but it'll be a little easier just to duplicate them too. So we'll right-click and copy them now, and then we'll drag them to the bottom. And we now have 3 llamas, 2 dots, and 2 stars. They are costumes 16 through 22. When we switch out the random block, we can use those numbers and see the llamas.